Hey guys, Guy Level here, and today we're gonna talk about the Elgato Stream Deck, which I don't have because I'm cheap. For those who don't know, the Elgato Stream Deck is a little device that sits on your table and has 15 LCD screen buttons that are fully customizable and programmable. It's basically one of the fanciest macro keyboards you can buy. It's mostly used by streamers who want a simple way to switch scenes, mute audio, or even send a going live tweet with the simple press of a button. But this video is dedicated to those who don't have the $150 price tag to invest in it. So we'll go over 5 alternatives to get your own free or at least cheap Elgato Stream Deck. Number one is called PowerGrid and it's free. It utilizes your mobile phone or tablet with a free software for your computer and an app for your mobile device. The software can be downloaded from the Rocat website. Rocat? And the app from Apple's App Store or Google's Play Store. The advantages are the ability to customize the buttons display, as well as the button size and position. Saving different profiles with different buttons, which gives a ton of possibilities. A good example would be having specific macros for a specific game, being able to operate it from anywhere around your house since it's wireless, the possibility to add delay in between keystrokes. This is really important because it helps your macros to work consistently with OBS. The disadvantages are the software doesn't exist for Apple computers, even though the app works on Apple mobile devices. That's weird, but that also means that if you have an iPhone and like a PC, it'll work just fine. You rely on your phone battery, and since you don't want to have it in sleep mode, it can drain your battery pretty fast. So I advise you to have it plugged in during the whole stream, but that makes it less mobile. Not being able to use your phone for other things. I usually advise streamers to not be on their phones during a stream, but some streamers use their phone to read chat. The Beta Cat made an in-depth tutorial on how to set it up. Links will be in the description. Number two is Macrodeck. It's also free and very similar to PowerGrid, except much simpler. The advantages are pretty much the same. Customizable button display, custom profiles, etc. also allows you to control certain functions of your computer, such as the volume, muting the mic, navigating in Explorer, and controlling your media players. The disadvantages are the same as the first one, but on top of that, it's not compatible with Apple products at all. Sorry. Blazing Nova made an in-depth tutorial on how to set it up. Links will be in the description. Number three, it's time to spend some money. This one requires an external numpad, wired or wireless, and a software called HID Macros. Of course, the price of this alternative depends on how cheap you can find a numpad for. You can even get a mechanical backlit one to be extra fancy. But to keep the cost low, I advise you to get a used one on Craigslist or something. You'll find some as low as $2. I actually made one myself. I wanted a brand new one and I wanted it to be wireless. I have enough cables already. So it cost me 17 euros on eBay with 24-hour shipping. The advantages are using HID macros recognizes your numpad as a separate device, which means it will not affect your main keyboard's numpad. I mostly stream creative, so I use a lot of shortcuts. I can't have macros overlapping my main keyboard, so this is perfect. I use simple inputs from F13 to F30 with a little bit of delay, so it works consistently. I printed my own labels and glued them with a clear glue that I had hanging around. I also added a coat of the same glue on top so it will survive wet or greasy fingers. The disadvantages. It was a bit tedious to set up at first. It took me a couple of errors to see how far I could push it and how many buttons I could actually use. It took me about 2 hours measuring the buttons, creating the Photoshop template, cutting, printing, gluing, and coding them. But I'm really pleased with the end result. ProtoAmp has a very cool tutorial on how to set it up. Links will be in the description. Number four. Number four will cost you a little bit of money, sweat, and probably a headache, but it might be the most satisfying one once completed. It's creating your own Stream Deck from scratch. Hear me out. The advantages are the ability to use whatever material you want. Make it the size you want, make it matte, make it shiny, make it light up, make it play sounds. The possibilities are endless. Of course, this alternative requires a good knowledge of microcontrollers, soldering, crafting, and a bit of coding. But the good news is that a lot of people already did that, so a bunch of tutorials are already available. Numero cinco. Number five is the easiest and doesn't cost anything.
Use your actual numpad.
If you play video games on stream and you don't use your numpad anyways, might as well turn it into a mini macro keyboard. I'd recommend using HID macros to create keybinds so it doesn't use the normal 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. While you're gaming. You can even go the extra mile and print stickers, just like I did for my external one. In conclusion, the more I search for cheap solutions, the more I realize that $150 is a pretty good price considering all the things that the Elgato Stream Deck can do. But personally, I enjoy the DIY aspect and the feeling of accomplishment this project gave me. I ended up using only 14 keys and it's perfect for my stream. Plus, there's an on-off button that helps me preserve battery when I'm not streaming. I'm currently working on some cool projects. You can follow me on Twitter to get some updates. You can also follow me on Twitch to see this bad boy in action. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If so, consider subscribing. Our 1k sub goal is so close, I can almost touch it. As always, thank you so much for watching. I will see you guys next time. Get a level out.